Now, I'm also grateful to all these beautiful and brave people who let me take their photos and stories for the last 20 years. Because of their stories and photos, I'm here today. Last 20 years, I have been always interested in the people who are living in the age of the society. I have been criticized for my work almost every day. People question my morals when I was working with gay community and sex workers. And they say I'm selling poverty when I was working with poor. But that was never my intention. I wanted to show the things that need to be changed positively. I wanted to show the things that need to be appreciated. I wanted to be a voice for those who have no voice. Twenty years is a long journey. I go through very different things, different life that nobody should go through. I'll show you some images and I'll talk about it. In Bangladesh, every day many people they go ride on the train roofs. They risk their life. They do it because they have no money to pay for the ticket. And it was very dangerous, and they do it every day. I was in the same position with her, just opposite of her. It was very dangerous to just stand there and taking the photos, but they do it every day. I got injured several times with the tree and electric wire. After August 2018, more than 7 million Rohingya refugees, they came to Bangladesh. Myanmar military was killing their families and burned their house, so they had to work day after days to come to Bangladesh. They were carrying their parents or families on their back. They were without food and water for a long time. She was crying because she could not eat anything last 3 days, and she was not able to feed her newborn baby. The situation was really bad. I was in Greece also covering the same situation. The refugees were crossing the sea and coming to the Greece from Syria, Iraq, and Afghanistan. And this father and son, they just arrived to Greece. They crossed the river with a rubber boat, which was overloaded, and it was about to sink. It was really difficult to see all these things and be, you know, and recording all this situation. The Dalit community in Bangladesh, even more, a lot of people, they even don't know this Dalit community, they exist. They have very difficult life. In some areas, people even don't talk to them. They don't let them go inside their shops. So they are untouchable. Sex workers in Bangladesh, in many brothels, there are many hundreds of young sex workers working there. They have been sold by their stepfather or stepmother, or by their boyfriend or husband, or somebody told them, come with me, I'll give you a job in a garments factory, and they sold them inside the brothel. And I was there, especially I pick one topic, and I work for a long time. Sometimes I work over 10 years, 5 years. It's a long time project. I only use my camera when they start trusting me. I just don't go there and take photos. I go there, I talk to them, I try to make them understand why I'm there, what I'm doing. When they start trusting me, then I take photos. So I was really close to them. I become one of them. And these girls, they get really depressed sometimes and they try to harm themselves. Lisa was crying because she lost everything. Now she's getting old and she's not getting client anymore. And she was really worried what will happen in her future. And suddenly she broke down and she was crying. Rana Plaza Cloths was the biggest textile industrial accident in Bangladesh, where more than thousands of people died. And many of them, they even did not get dead bodies of their families. Still, people go there to remembering that area, to remembering all their beloved. I was also in Pakistan. I mainly work in South Asian countries, in Bangladesh, India, Nepal, Pakistan, Sri Lanka, Bhutan, these areas. So I travel a lot for these stories. This is a ship-breaking yard in Pakistan, and they have to break whole ships with their hands, and they get really low paid. They're all workers from Peshawar. A lot of women and children every day working in a dumping yard in Bangladesh. They start working from early morning to late afternoon. They're collecting materials for recycling. And if you talk to them, they never complain about anything. They're smiling. I don't know what makes them smile. And we have everything in our life, and we always complain almost everything. And we should not regret anything, you know. Today we are here, we are fortunate, actually. Many of people, they even did not wake up this morning. So if you are here, you are breathing, you are alive, you should appreciate. You don't need anything else in your life. Just be happy and enjoy the moment. There are thousands of people who have nothing. They even cannot eat twice a day. This is a home for elderly people in Nepal. The condition was very bad. This authority, they even could not supply food for twice a day. And I did this story for international magazines. After publishing these stories, a lot of international organizations came forward and the situation improved a lot. This is in Indonesia. More than 7 million mental patients are not getting proper treatment there. They don't have enough doctors also. So mainly the patients are caged and chained. And they were screaming all the time. Still, after I took these images long time ago, still I can hear this screaming. So when you are a photographer, you have to carry all these things in your whole life. Sometimes it makes you really sad, sometimes make you really depressed. And it was not easy also taking photos. Somebody is, you know, chained and you are taking photos. It was really difficult to see all these things. I have a Facebook page and Instagram page where every day I post one photo, stories. They are incredible stories, heartbreaking stories, inspiring stories. And I receive mail from all around the world, hundreds of mails every day, how these images and stories are changing people's life, their way of thinking, their way of perspective. They become more kind to people. You should check. This man, he was beating this boy because he was slow. He was sewing a T-shirt for another children. More than 7 million children are working in Bangladesh, almost every factory. And they have very bad situation. Their parents cannot earn enough money, so they have to send their children to work. And this working condition is really, the light is very low. They have to touch many different kinds of toxic chemicals. The owner of the factories, they like to keep children because they cannot complain. They can keep them longer, and they can pay less money. In every factory, you'll say, and it's very difficult condition. This boy, he's lost his one hand while he was working in these factories, and when he recovered, he came back again to work in these factories. The situation is very complex. This boy was chained by his father because he get drug addicted, mingles with other street boys. So every day, his father bring him to this factory, chained him. When the work is done, he take him to home. The situation is really complex. I talked to the owner of the factories, and they say if you don't give job to these children, they will go on the street and they will do a lot of other things. I was really depressed to seeing all these things because I really wanted to do something for these people. I did not started photography only for, you know, showing it, or I really wanted to do something for these people. And I came up and I stopped taking photos. In some times of my life, I become really depressed. I stopped taking photos anymore. So I wanted to do something for people. I came up with idea that I'll give them a small business. So I start talking with them and find out what kind of business they're able to do. I research on the market. I start the business and I give them business as a gift. And I monitor them and give them training after several months. So far, I have given 65 different business to 65 different families. Munna's family is one of those 65 families. Munna's father is a cobbler, so he cannot earn enough money, so he sent Munna to work in a factories. I can see Munna's hands looks like a 60-year-old man hands. And after talking several meetings, I give cucumber business to him. And cucumber is a definitely good business because there are more than 6,000 restaurants in Dhaka who need cucumber every day for making salad. So it's definitely a good business. In 3 months, he was starting good amount of money. He bring out Munna from the factory and Munna back to the normal life. You see, Munna looks totally different. He was playing, he was smiling. And he was also working with father. Whatever he was earning, he was supporting his sister education. Shojib also working in a factory. I gave her women dress selling business. So she buy women dress from a wholesale market and sell to the door to door. And she start earning more money. So she also bring Shojib from the factory. Only you can improve the situation on the child level if you really give them support. So the parents of the children, they can earn more money. I did a lot of work on ST children in Bangladesh more than 3.2 million children are living on the street in every city of Dhaka, in Bangladesh. And a lot of them, they are getting involved with taking drugs. And I met these three children, they were still fresh, and they wanted to change their life. So after several meetings of them, they start trusting me, and I told them, I want to give you business rather than you are living on the street. And they start trusting me. They were all dirty. They were, did not take shower for 15 days. They were very dirty. I took them, cut their hair, cut their nails, give them shower in a public place, buy new dress for them, and give them popcorn business. So they were selling popcorn in front of a school. And in first day, I also sell popcorn with them to show how to talk, how to behave with people. And I was looking at other people that I took photos 5 years ago, 10 years ago. It was not easy. I was going everywhere, showing the images and looking for these people. I really wanted to help this woman, Shaira Begum. She lost her everything because of the cyclone, Ayla. And I set up a business for her son, vegetable business. He buys vegetables from a wholesale market and sell it in a local market. Also give him a rickshaw van so he can transport the vegetables. Samsuddin Chacha used to carry toys in his shoulder. It was very difficult for him in this age. So I give him a customized van where he sells shoes. I give him a shoe business. Fatima was about to send her two sons to work as a day laborer because they were her husband got paralyzed suddenly and they could not survive. They had nothing. So I set up a grocery shop for them and admitted these two boys into school. I gave many different business to different people. In village, it's very difficult to give business, actually, because very few buyers is there. So, and also difficult to get the space. So I use a part of the house to set up these businesses. I gave a cows to Saleha Khala. When I met her, she told me, give me a calf. I'll take care of the calf, and when the calf will give me milk, grow up, give me milk, I'll change my life. She had no idea. After 1 week, I went there with cow and calf. And in next year, they have another calf from their cow. So you can see the changes. And I follow these people for a long time. It's not just I'm going there and taking photos or helping them, I'm going away. I'm with them whole my life. I keep communicate all the time. This is Kurshada. Her husband died and they had a very difficult life. So I give sewing machine for her daughter so they can earn money, also give her cow. Rudro, his father got paralyzed, and I took responsibility for his education for the last 4 years, also give them cow. Why cow? Cow is a very profitable business because it's give milk. They can sell milks 3 or 4 kilo every day. So they can earn 200 taka every day almost. So this is a very good business. I gave rickshaw to Farooq. He lost his rickshaw, and he was working in a dumping yard. It was very difficult for him to earn more money. Shanta was chained by her father. Because she mingled, his father is a cobbler, far away to earn more money, and she got involved with bad children and got drugged. I took her in a hospital, gave her treatment, and gave a rickshaw van vegetable business again to his father so he can give more time to her. Kausal lost his one hand while he was driving a rickshaw, and he started begging. And he took this photo. He managed 2 years' money, saved the new dress for her daughter, and I give vegetable business to him. So he's not begging anymore. This is Ontumoni's mother. She sent Ontumoni, because they're very poor, they cannot earn enough money. She sent Ontumoni to another person's house to work as a maid. So I bring her back to her mother and admitted her in a college and took her whole responsibility for her education. This is the same case of Anika. She was also was crying. She could not manage her educational fee. So I admitted her in a college. I took responsibility for other 30 students who cannot pay for the education. I set up a school with 40 children 4 years back in a rural area. And now I have 160 children. They're getting... So I built up this school, and they're getting their education almost free. I also do a lot of other activities. Every year I distribute shoes or sandals among working children and street children. I distribute new dress among working children and street children. I distribute school bag among poor students, toys among working children, winter shawl for working women who cannot afford. the new dresses for, during the Eid festival among the poor people and single mother. I started photography school in Dhaka now, First Lady Institute of Photography. Whatever I earn from this school, all this money I use for doing all these activities. I started also tuk-tuk business. So these three tuk-tuk, whatever the earning, they're supporting this three family. I published my photography book 5 years ago. So when I sell this book, all the money goes to support these families. Many international magazines, they send the reporters to Bangladesh to interview these people I help. And they publish many articles on about it. And it was really inspiring. And they also try to help these people. I'm going to finish it. I just want to share one quote that always inspired me. I'm the only one, but still I'm the one. I cannot do everything, but still I can do something. Because I cannot do everything, I will not refuse to do something that I can do. Thank you very much. All these stories and people, they have made me a better human being every day. Thank you very much.